okay, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Okay, ovules are naked, not are not enclosed both before and after fertilization in gymnosperms. Okay, in angiosperms, ovules enclosed by ovary. Ovules enclosed by ovary. Enclosed means closed. The ovules are closed. In this, ovules are naked, not enclosed. Okay, by any ovary. So, in this, fruit is absent. In this, fruit is formed. After fertilization, ovules modify into seeds, ovary forms fruit. So, it is fruited plants. And it is fruited vascular plants. And these gymnosperms are embryophytic, brachiophytic, and archegoniates. Archegoniates. And also they possess seeds. They are also they are belongings to spermatophytic. And these are also spread out the seeds. That's why it is called spermatophytic. Spermatophytic. It is archegoniates. It is non-archegoniates. Non-archegoniates. And in this gymnosperms, tallest tree is found. That is Sequoia sempervirensis. Tallest tree is Sequoia sempervirensis. Sequoia sempervirensis. That is rosewood tree. Rosewood tree. Found in gymnosperms. And also in this tallest tree, that is tallest tree in plant kingdom. Sequoia sempervirensis, tallest tree in plant kingdom. And also Ginkgo biloba is considered as living fossil. Ginkgo biloba is considered as living fossil. Okay, in this plants, angiospermic in the world. Smallest angiosperm is Ulfia punctata. Ulfia punctata, it is a hydrophytic plant. And also tallest angiospermic plant is called Eucalyptus gigantea. Eucalyptus gigantea. Okay. And also in this plant body is sporophyte. In this also plant body is sporophyte. It is diploid. And it is sporophyte is divided into three parts. Root and leaves and stem. Root and leaves and stem. In angiosperms, the plant body that is sporophyte has three parts. Root, leaves and stem. And also in this root system is taproot system. And sometimes taproot forces coralline roots towards to opposite of gravity force, which is associated with Naster fix, nitrogen fixing bacteria. Nitrogen fixing cyanobacteria is associated. And best example cypress. And sometimes and roots are mycorrhiza is present in fungus. In this roots are common. Taproot system and in dicots, taproot system in dicotyledons, fibrous or apodictic system in monocotyledons, and leaves are pinnately compounding in cycles, and needle-like in pinus, simple leaves present in needle. Okay, and leaves in gymnosperms, xerophytic adaptations, gymnosperms, leaves of gymnosperms showing xerophytic adaptations. And in these leaves are simple leaves and compound leaves. Okay, in this stem, the stem is aerial, unbranched, best example, cycas, branched, final stages. Okay, and also this in this stem is stem of the vascular bundles are arranged in circular form, is called eustachian. The vascular bundle type is conjoint, collateral, open type. Okay, in this secondary growth is found in roots and stem. And also in stems, in the stems of the angiosperms is aerial and branched. In this leaves eustachian and vascular bodies are also called conjoint collateral open type. But in this secondary growth is planted in dicot stem, but it is absent in monoplant, except Glaucina and Eucla. In Glaucina and Eucla is monocotyledons. Okay, monocotyledons, that is belongs to Liliaceae members. Best example, Glaucina and Glaucina angustifolia, Eucla gloriosa. It is participating in secondary growth. That secondary growth is called anomalous growth development, abnormal secondary growth development. Okay, this is the main difference between gymnosperms and angiosperms based on vegetative parts.